How to create Gmail filters today on the 1 Minute Tech Tip. Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? At dottotech, we make technology easy so you can do more. And the thing I want to teach you to do more of today is to use Gmail filters to help organize your email. Now, there's a lot of different ways to create filters, but I'm just going to show you one way, which I think is the easiest way to create a Gmail filter to allow you to kind of gain a little more control over your email life. When you receive an email that you want to do the same action on an ongoing basis. Now, for example, I get notifications from my website. I'd like to save those notifications somewhere just in case I have to go back and look at them, but I don't want to look at each and every one because it just fills up and clogs up my inbox. So here's how we can create a filter for that. So you click on the message first, and then there's a drop-down menu here that allows you to filter messages like this. When we open that up, it gives us different criteria for how to filter the message. It can be from the sender, it can be the subject to, or has the words in it. Now, I'm going to choose the subject as the filter because all of the messages from my website come with this text that says, dottotech, please moderate. So see that those words right there? I'm just going to copy that because I'm going to use that when I create the filter. So let's go back in now and let's say, please filter messages like these one more time. And now in the subject, I'm going to put the text that's in there. Please moderate. And so that's going to identify all of these messages that come from my website. And I'm going to ask it to create the filter. Once it creates the filter, this gives me the options of what I'm going to do with that filter. I can archive it right away. So I can just choose here to skip the inbox, which will archive it. Now, it's still going to be there in Gmail's archive, so I can search for it if I need it in the future, if I need to find it, but it's not going to clutter up my inbox all the time. Before you save the filter, make sure you click here to apply this filter to matching conversations. So it'll go through now and it'll clean all of the messages out of my inbox that I've been too lazy to clean out. So now what's going to happen is when we go back to our inbox, it will have moved all of those emails out of my inbox, never to be seen by me again unless I go looking for them. That is the easiest way to create Gmail filters. I love reading your comments and suggestions, so please post below. I do read every single one. If you like this video, please give it a like and share it with your friends or colleagues who may find it useful. Now make sure you've subscribed and hit that notification bell. And if you have time, check out some of our other videos right over there. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.